Removing internal traffic from your website reports helps you improve accuracy in your data. In today's SEO Thursday video, we're going to show you how to remove an IP address from Google Analytics. Hi, my name is John Hoey. I'm the SEO manager here at The Marketing People. Before we go into this episode, what I need to do is head over to youtube.com and remember to subscribe to the Marketing People channel. We offer lots of helpful videos, hints and tips and advice on all of your marketing needs. So today's video, how to remove an IP address from Google Analytics. Now, just to give you a quick overview of Google Analytics, it's a free tool that Google offers that you just put a bit of code into your website and it tracks visitors to your site. It can offer shows where they're coming from, and it can also show people what they're doing while they're there. But what you need to do is make sure that you've set it up correctly. If you don't, your reports will show an unrealistic increase in traffic to your website. It will also give you and your potential clients inaccurate data, and this will have a knock-on effect and harm conversion rates. Now, Google automatically includes your IP address in its analytics, and therefore it will show data. So if you've landed on your website yourself, that will automatically be tracked and anyone else with the same IP address. So if you've got a business with several users all accessing the website at the same time, all under different IP address or one IP address, then every time that they land on the site, that will be tracked and added. Therefore, the reports will show inaccurately. However, as this video shows, we're gonna give you a quick and easy solution on how to exclude an IP address or exclude users in Google Analytics, so it offers a lot more accurate reflection in your reports. First of all, what I need you to do is to, in Google, type in Google Analytics, and then we're gonna be using this top link here, so it's analytics.google.com. So if you just click in there, it will then load up your admin form. Now, all you need to do is click in the bottom left-hand corner, click on the admin button. What this will do, this will show up the admin area for your website. We're gonna be using a test view here because we've already got pre-populated filters already built into the main account, which is this, all filters on the left-hand side. Now, I would probably recommend you look to include some of your filters on the main account going forward. So if this is new to you, add them in here. But always remember to create a raw data property within here so it covers, so you've not got anything excluded. But for this instance, because we've already got filters already added in view, we're just going to add a filter in here. So, okay, so we've clicked in view. Now, click on filters. We're going to add filter to view. We're going to create a new filter. Then we're going to, in the filter name, just put exclude my IP address, which is great. Then in filter type, we're going to use the predefined setting. And you can use a custom setting, which is good if you're looking to have lots more advanced areas within your website and lots more advanced tracking in there. But for this instance, we're just going to use a predefined, and we're going to exclude an IP address. We're gonna, and this drop down here, we're gonna just select traffic from IP address that is equal to, and then we're gonna add your IP in here. Now, if you're thinking, okay, well, how do I find out my IP address? I don't know. If you go to Google, again, really simple, type in what's my IP address, then just visit whatismyipaddress.com. This will show you both an IP version 4 and the newer version, IP version 6. So just preferably we use IP version 4, and just make sure that your IP address is also a fixed or static IP address. Now, a lot of businesses use fixed or static IP addresses so it's easier to maintain. Public IP addresses, say if you're working from home, not very accurate with these in this area for Google Analytics, purely because it can change if you reset your router or if you reset your computer, that type of thing. Now, that's why we say use a fixed or static IP address for your reporting needs. Now, All you do is put that IP address in here. Here's a default one, which is fairly standard, 192.168.0.1. The difference between an IP version 4 and an IP version 6 is that an IP version 4 will, as you see on screen, it's usually around 8, 9, 10 characters long. A public IP for version 6, it's going to be 35 to 40 characters. So then all we need to do is click Save. There we have it. And from this point in time, as soon as you hit save there, you can see in the filter, as soon as you hit save, it automatically starts tracking or excluding your traffic from that IP address throughout the website. That's why we say it's important to have create a new view or a new property within your Google Analytics. So you've got raw data. So in case there's any inaccuracies there, so you've got like raw data and then you've got this new view with this new filter added as well, just to track data going forward. So that's all for today. Thanks ever so much for watching. If you'd like to get in touch with us, if you're interested in any of our services, give us a call. The number is 01543 495 752. Send us an email, info@themarketingpeople.com. And remember to check us out on all social media sites. And remember to sign up to youtube.com and search for The Marketing People and click subscribe. Thanks for watching.